What's up, what's up, guys? Bitcoin Overdose here, your daily dose of crypto. I overdose, so you guys do not have to. Now, I'm sorry, guys. Again, I've been away for so long, and I feel like coming back is a good thing. But guys, so I'm back to my charts. This is the fun part. Bitcoin TA, plus everything else going on. Now, definitely go follow me over at Bitcoin Overdose. I am doing a giveaway at 200 followers. So if you guys follow me for just 31 more people, I will do a giveaway and I will let you guys know more about that if I do get up there. Also, hit that subscribe button to stay tuned every day because it is important to stay tuned to this crypto sphere. Every day things are changing. And today we got some important news, guys. Very important news up in the CSEC area. SEC, not CSEC. I don't know what that is. But anyways, 9,300 is what we're sitting at right now for Bitcoin, guys. Good thing though, market cap is kind of recovering from yesterday's drop of about 30 million in 2 hours or something like that. But I mean, guys, looking at the monthly, we are headed up so well from just a couple of weeks ago. Looking at the 3 month, guys, we had that huge ass dip here. Year to date, I mean, damn, you can just tell. We hit 830 with our top, and then now we're all the way back down to 442, looking to make that turn up towards 500 again, or 443. I apologize, guys, for all of you people out there. Anyways, Bitcoin dominance is still hanging around that 35% area. It is dropping slowly by the day, and this other category is catching up, and I think that was guessed upon last time. This year, you know, guys, we thought it was going to be the year for the alts. So, you know, let it be known. Anyways, the altcoins aren't doing too well today. Bitcoin's down is 2%. So that means that everything else against Bitcoin is trading pretty down, except for EOS. I don't know how EOS is kind of holding up here, but it's going up 6% today. Good thing you got a big bag of EOS, right, guys? Anyways, Zilliqa is still holding up there too. Ontology is as well. I don't know what Ontology is, but guys, it's creeping into that top 30. So is Zilliqa. So I don't know why I don't own any. I sold my 0x. I'm really sorry. I did it like 10,000 BTC or whatever. I should have held 18,000 now. I could have gotten my 2x back or 4x back or whatever the heck I had it at. That's actually really sad to me. Anyways, Loom Network is somehow the one booming today at 20%. I don't know exactly what this is. Got a lower market cap, and you know, it seems to have just gotten listed somewhere. I don't know what the news is on this. The next generation blockchain platform for large online games and social apps. So I don't know what Loom Network exactly is. Actually, let me dApp generator. Seems like an easy way to build something, but what is the social aspect? Because that's actually what we need since Facebook sucks. I'm not too sure, guys. It's a real blockchain though. Okay, yeah, so I don't really know what the news is on that. Maybe it got listed on Binance. That's probably what it is, honestly, because I've never seen this before. Let's see if Binance listed it. XRP trading pair, nano competition, April gas, float coin. Oh, there we go. 502. So yep, you got listed on Binance, and of course that means it's gonna sky. It's too bad you didn't get in down here. I feel like this will correct, so don't jump in quite yet. But it's only been in here for 4 days. Oh, it already had its correction. So never mind, it's just kind of booming because it is. I don't know, guys. I do not know. But that's too bad that I missed that one. I don't know, it would have been cool to know. Anyways, I don't know if Loom will stay in the top 100, but we will keep going down. Anything else? Oh, Funfair is having a good day. And Bitcoin Dark. Again, I don't know what Bitcoin Dark. Well, I know what it is, obviously, but I don't know why it's zooming so high. Guys, this has gone ridiculous. The last month, had you gotten in, you would have already like quadrupled your investment. So, you know, whatever. Yeah, no, that's it for top 100. I'm gonna zoom out back into this. Yeah, guys, just looking at this, I mean, this day is about to close. You know, we got about 2 hours. We're gonna see if we close green here. On the daily, we are holding our own in between this 1107 and 6600 range. I think there's really good support around 8800. I think it's what we saw. I'm going to put a light support there because it does make sense to hold that line. We do need to hold up there, guys. We cannot have any more of this trickling across shit. You know, we can't just keep on dipping and whatnot. It's going to be a while, though, I think, before we really see the bulls come in, because they are waiting on what I was saying earlier, guys, the whole fiasco with the SEC. So today they are discussing on the government side of things if Ethereum is a security or not. So I would expect a huge drop if they figure this out soon. Short term, long term, I think it's still going to be fine because it's only the US government. You know, but usually financial wise, every government kind of follows the US. So I guess we will see what happens. All eyes on Ethereum for right now. Looks like they didn't come to a decision today because it didn't dip immensely or it didn't pump immensely. But I figure it would go one way or the other if it does come down to that decision, whatever it may be. Now, government, of course, I don't expect them to get something done right away. They normally take a little while. They talk it out. They, you know, decide over the course of the next month or so, maybe. But, you know, if they do figure something out, that will be which way Ethereum ends up going for the short term. Again, long term, I don't think it really matters. Guys, this circulating supply always changes. I forgot how many Ethereum there actually are, but there's more every time that they're mined, so it's kind of weird. But yeah, so it'll be an interesting time. It might just be all FUD. The meeting was never scheduled. The only source was the Wall Street Journal, and clearly they have no clue WTF they're talking about. I called the SEC, and the security stated that even if a meeting was it would be closed doors made to the public only after taking place. Thank you, a true investigator. Love that you called them. At least he asked, just hit up Reddit. I do the same thing, guys. Well, about that. Anyways, that's funny. So the SEC never actually happened, and that's all a rumor, and that's all FUD, and I don't really know what else to say. Oh, follow me, trader, because this guy's cool. Peace out, guys. You guys have a great rest of your day. Come back tomorrow. Hit that subscribe button. Go follow me over on Twitter for that giveaway at 200 followers, and bye.